Hi guys, in this Blender tutorial, I'll show you how to model a head, apply materials, set up light and cameras, and how to render a turntable animation. You're watching TNT Tutorials, let's move on! Choose General. In top right panel, select Camera and Light, and delete them. You can see all hotkeys and mouse clicks on the left. Feel free to pause video and check them. On the right lower, we have Modified Properties. Let's add Subdivision Surface. I'll subdivide cube and hit apply. On the top right, I'll press toggle X-ray. Then enter edit mode. Select vertices and delete them. Object mode. Move this one up. Duplicate it and rotate. Let's select them both and join. Edit mode, choose Edge Select and select both edges. Right-click and find Bridge Edge Loops. Now we have a panel on the bottom left, and I'll adjust number of cuts. Object mode and subdivide. Let's add another cube, adjust it and change proportions. I'll enter material properties on the bottom right, click New and scroll down to the bottom. Let's change color for viewport and enter edit mode. On the top left, we have face select. I'll pick it and select two faces. In this case, it's better to use inset before subdividing. It will keep borders from over-smoothing. Let's subdivide. I'll enter object mode and make a few simple adjustments. We need to reflect ear, so let's add mirror modifier. Grab eyedropper and click on head. I'll change color for head also. The same beginning for eyes. We start with cube, subdivision and basic adjustments. Mirror modifier, eyedropper, and click on head. Let's add pupils and quickly apply viewport color to have better picture. Apply mirror and I think you're ready for more useful stuff. Add cube and adjust it like this. Edit mode. Select face and extrude. Hotkey is E. The same here. We can toggle X-ray. Select vertices. Move them and even use scale to change geometry. I'll add bevel, adjust it and subdivide shape. We'll do the same with cheeks as we did with ears, but we'll add cool modifier, which has very many ways to use. Now pay attention. We need to select Origin to Geometry, and this is crucial. You're already familiar with Inset, one of the most common features. Let's subdivide. Go to Object Mode and apply Subdivision. Take a look on top panel. I'll select the gimbal here. Now let's add simple deform modifier. Select Bend, Z axis, and apply needed angle. Next is mirror. I'll add circle this time. Apply all transforms after adjusting it. Switch to edit mode and play with vertices. Let's adjust bevel depth. Right-click and select Shade Flat. It's better to lower resolution to make sure that topology will be perfect after subdividing. Let's enter X-ray mode and delete these faces. Object mode. Turn off X-ray and apply mirror. Get rid of gaps by adjusting merge value. I'll enter sculpt mode to quickly finish lip shape. In these cases, grab will work the best. Now we can return to object mode, subdivide lips, and apply viewport color. We start with a plane this time. I'll change viewport color. And now look at the top panel. I hit snap and then snap to face. This is crucial. Enter edit mode and pick shrink wrap modifier. Select outside surface. Eyedropper, click on head. Now I'll set value for offset and we can continue. Take a look on the bottom left. We'll use poly build. It's very easy as you can see. Mirror modifier as usual. Poly build allows to move vertices like this. In the end, set 0 for offset, enter object mode, and apply all modifiers. Let's add solidify and adjust thickness. Applied also. Now subdivide. Bevel. We can bring bevel up and you can see the difference. I'll play with values a bit and you can see what we get. Apply all modifiers. Now it's time to get more advanced with this beautiful method. You probably already can tell what we'll do first here. There's many things which we quickly repeat over and over. Shrink wrap, target head, edit mode and grab poly build. I'll turn off lips for now. You can see closed eye in the top right window. In this case we hold Ctrl, new polygon will appear, click with left mouse button to approve creation, and after this grab vertex and drag it. This is how it goes. Create only rectangles. Only 4 corners, not 5 or 3. Here I'll select 2 edges and simply press F key to connect them. As you can see, I always edit mesh to make it decent. Learn to do the same. Here I don't have enough polygons, so I'll use loop cut to divide polygon and have 2 polygons out of it. Now everything will be just perfect. Let's decrease shrink wrap offset to 0. Go to object mode, apply shrink wrap, select solidify and adjust it. Let's fix this with merge value in the mirror modifier. I'll apply all modifiers and add a few loops to prevent edges from over-smoothing. Time for subdivision. Now watch this and pay attention. Right-click here and select Vertical Split. In this menu, select Image Editor. Click on Open and import any color palette you want. Take a look at the top right, I'll select Viewport Shading Mode. Then enter Material Properties, click on Base Color and pick Color from Palette. You can download colors and finished 3D model on my Patreon and be able to move or change anything in this model in Blender on your own. Let's join areas and add a camera. Vertical split again, and this time we'll choose camera view. I'll add a spotlight source, and you can see that we treat camera and lights just like any other objects. Feel free to pause video and watch my light settings if you need. Now it's time to subdivide each object, apply all effects, and adjust material roughness. I'll duplicate light sources and change power, radius, and size for each of them. There's a rim light on a back, which will have the highest power. Now let's add empty plane axis. Drag this panel up. And add to 300 frames here. I'll move axis down a bit and assign a first rotation keyframe. Then add keyframe at 150. Move to the last frame. Press R, Z, enter 180 and add another keyframe. Let's delete middle keyframe and see how it works. Take a look at top right. I'll open this little menu and select Graph Editor. Select keyframes and change handle type to vector. It's time to parent camera and light sources to empty. Select them all. Ctrl plus P. And parent them to transform. And now we have what we wanted. This is my render settings. You can copy them and play with them on your own to see what will work for you the best. Here you can select where to save render. Make sure you have the same settings as I show right now, because they are the best for video with transparent background. I will render a test picture and then select render animation in the same menu. 30 seconds for one frame is not bad, but I think I could achieve even 28 seconds. As we have our animation render done, let's jump into DaVinci Resolve Studio, which is also a free software. I'll import animation here and create a solid color background. Then duplicate animation to make it 1 minute long, apply color, and that's it. This is how you model a head and render turntable animation in Blender. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to press thumbs up and subscribe for more tutorials like this. This was TNT Tutorials. See you in the next video!